Hello, I'm Brendan Nolan, and I'm a storyteller. That's what I do. I'm a professional storyteller. I am also a writer, but books are mostly, 10 of them are mostly to do with storytelling. So some thoughts on telling stories, just for now. To tell a story well, we as storytellers must see the story dance in our mind's eye. Doesn't mean we're seeing things, it just means that the story is so real that we can see it in our mind's eye, we can see what's happening. For a storyteller in telling conjures up demons in the most peaceful mind. Our love in the hardest of hearts. Our challenges in the midday sun. Perhaps you've been in a warm climate where there's been a mirage across a desert, perhaps. And tantalizing images dance away in the heat. And they're moving and they're moving. And it's not certain that they're there, or whether it's your eye or it's the imagination that's doing it. So you must try to do the same in the storytelling. Because then you'll enjoy the storytelling as much as the listener will. Because you are there in the heat and the dance. And perhaps you see a pair of intertwined footsteps on a snowy path. And it suggests to you or reminds you of lovers walking along their enchanted way. Remember that? Perhaps you know it just now. How wondrous the exuberance of new love recently discovered. Oh, the breath catches in the throat. We may never breathe properly again. What? Tell it in the story and tell it out for us all to hear. Make goosebumps appear on our skin as we listen. For a storyteller's mind must dance to create the reality of imagination. Remember that, the reality of imagination. Wow, that's alchemy at work, is it not? Oh, it must be. It must be magic. You, the storyteller, must see the mirage. Meet the demon, embrace the lovers. And at the end, the listener must be worn out as much as the teller is spent on creating an oasis for thirsty travellers in a land of wonder. For then, a story has been told. You. Storyteller. Wow. You are the alchemist. Wow. I'm reminded of a story of two lovers that I included in my book, Irish Love Stories, for I thought so much of it. And briefly, Aengus is the god of love and poetry in mythological times. And one night, he's unable to sleep on a warm summer's night, and he's tossing and turning, and the door of his room opens. And he wonders who it is, for there are guards outside to protect him. And a young woman of his own age, for Aengus was a young man at this time, he was a young god, and the girl came in, and she had an instrument with her. And she began to sing and play music he had never heard before. And it was so enchanting that he just listened and listened and listened. And when it was done, he wondered what might happen next, for he was afraid to move on the bed or move from his position in case she might vanish. And she didn't come any closer to him. But when morning came, and the grey light of dawn crept across the floorboards of his bedchamber. She opened the door and she was gone. But she came the next night and she did the same thing. And each night after that, for a long time, she came and sang. And she never spoke and he never spoke. And then one night she did not appear. And he searched the countryside with some people searching for her and could not find her. And he stopped eating and drinking for want of her. And his mother Boann came in with the oldest, wisest doctor in Ireland, for Boann was a god in her own right, a god of the Tuatha Dé Danann. And the old doctor said, well, find the girl and he will be cured. So they went to the Dagda, the supreme leader of the Tuatha Dé Danann in mythological Ireland, and he was the father of Aengus, and he made an order that she be found, and she was found, but she was under a spell. And the spell was that she and her companions would be changed into swans on the first day of November. Samhain, we call it now in the Irish tradition. And for a year they would fly off all over Ireland as swans. And in 1 year's time, they would return to the lake they had taken off from. Well, Aengus heard of this and he swept down through Ireland and he found her. And he said to her, I waited for you. I waited and waited and waited. Why did you not come to me? And Care, or that was her name, said, I wanted to. I wanted to be with you as much as you wanted me, but I'm under a spell. But if you come back in 1 year's time and we are finished as swans, I will become a person again and I will go with you for a year and be your friend and we will enjoy ourselves. Whole year just to do it. And off they flew, and a year later he was back waiting for her, and 150 swans landed on the lake, and one of them was Care. And she said, tomorrow, my love. And he said, no, I won't wait another day. I'm the god of love and poetry, and I will cast a spell. And stronger than the spell you were under. Now, if you're hearing this story for the first time, as I did once upon a time, you might think that his spell would be to change Care into a person forever, but instead it wasn't that. He did something entirely different. He stepped into the water, and as he sank lower and lower, he was transformed into a beautiful swan. And when all the other swans had left the lake and become people for a year, he and Care swam and swam and swam faster and faster and faster down the lake until finally they took out their wings, spread their wings, and they flew away to be together forever. Care and Aengus. Aengus and Care. Lovers. For listening. If you like what we're doing here, down below you can see a little thumb like that. Just press that and like it for us if you would. And if you want to be notified of new videos in this series, please just press subscribe below and you will be notified. Thank you very much.